for environmental impact assessment as well as to understand the behavior of the part one constructed, numerical modeling is generally adopted nowadays. Earlier we used to do a physical model also, but only important projects now we do a physical model. The physical model is generally done in India at a place called Central Water Power Research Station in Pune. We have one major port for defense coming on the east coast for which they have the model set up there. But this class we will be seeing, we will be discussing about the numerical model. The port requires breakwaters, berths, dredging. The dredging is in the berthing areas, harbor basin, training circle and approach channel. All these things were prepared by Department of Ocean Engineering, and the design of breakwater, design of berths, methodology for dredging, disposal, and what is the berthing area, harbor basin area, training circle area, approach channel, everything comes under detailed project report. We also give the cost estimate. Indomar Coastal Hydraulics is a private company. This has carried out the mathematical modeling studies, but this type of studies can also be done in our department. We also have the software as well as commercial as well as in-house softwares developed also are available. So, in this lecture we will see the approach for carrying out this numerical model, what are the methodologies adopted and the results. We use a software called Mike 21. This is used for calculation of combined current and wave induced non-cohesive sediment transport rate at offshore beyond the wave breaking zone. That is the capability of this model. Basically, we want to study how much sediment will be disturbed. So, we will be discussing about three aspects. One is the sediment transport. The next one what we will be doing is we will be discussing about the tranquility. The third one we will discuss about the shoreline evaluation. These are the three aspects which we will be discussing. So, all this studies are required because we have constructed the breakwater and that will create some erosion and deposition. This is the layout of the breakwater, almost symmetrical. I am showing the result. The result is for three seasons. One is fair weather, northeast monsoon and southwest monsoon. So, for fair weather the sediment flux will be less. The unit for sediment flux is how many meter cube of sediment per year per meter width, that is per meter width. Mostly the studies are concentrated beyond the breaker zone, that is if there is a 1 meter wave, if there is a 0.78 meter wave that will break in 1 meter contour. So, this model estimate beyond the wave breaker zone how much sediment will be transported. There is a arrow indicated which is 50 meter cube per year per meter width, that is per meter width is this per meter width, and the length of the arrow indicates this is 50 meter cube, this may be around 10 or 15 meter cube, that is what it shows. We are giving one more color code, this is 5 millimeter per day, that is the rate at which the deposition take place is about 5 meter per day, 5 millimeter per day. So, there is an entrance channel which is here. So, in this area during fair weather season there is a deposition, that rate is given in meter per day, that means it will be about 10 millimeters or 10 centimeter, this one 0.01. There is a negative sign here, that means there is a erosion. Is it clear? There is a deposition as well as erosion. Generally, the deposition quantity and erosion quantity is the same. So, this channel in this area, there is a deposition. Somewhere here, there is a erosion which is taking place. This is calculated as 0.5 into 10 power 6 meter cube for about 4 month duration. So, we have 1 year period, out of which 4 month are fair weather. During that, the maintenance dredging is estimated about 0.5 into 10 power 6 cubic meter. The purpose of this sediment transport analysis is to find out how much will be the sediment transport and how much will be the siltation. This is the southwest monsoon. So, compared to the fair weather season, you can see for the southwest monsoon, the sediment flux has increased from 50 to 100 to 200 meter cube. So, this on the seaside of both the breakwaters, that is, this is the southern breakwater, this is the northern breakwater, this is the seaward side of these breakwaters, it is about 250 cubic meter. This shows the deposition and this shows the erosion. So, southwest monsoon, the waves will be coming from this side. This volume of maintenance dredging is about 1 into 10 power 6 cubic meter for about 4 month duration. This is the southwest monsoon. Here also you can see what is the deposition rate. The entrance channel is getting deposited like this. Now you tell me, what does this blue color indicate? Why it is depositing this side? Because the wave direction is like this, depositing here, and this will be erosion. And if you see the previous figure, the deposition was somewhere here, this side of the channel, whereas here it is on the other side of the channel. And northeast monsoon is also about 100 to 200 cubic meter, but this quantity is also estimated to be 1 into 10 power 6 cubic meter for 4 month duration. But this is not the general behavior. If you summarize, you have seen this is 5 into 10 power 5. It is 0.5 into 10 power 6 cubic meter. This is 1 into 10 power 6. This is 1 into 10 power 6. So, this is the maintenance dredging is for a length of about 13 kilometers long channel with 16 meter depth, is about 2.5 million cubic meter per annum. This is the total quantum that is required. You understood the purpose of doing this study? First, what we have to do is, we have to carry out a bathymetric survey. Then we have to find out what should be the width of the channel. Last class I discussed what is the width, what is the length of the channel. Length of the channel is very long, 13 kilometer, because at a distance of 13 kilometer only, you have natural depth of 16 meters available. This is not an ideal location for a port. Typically, the 16 meter contour should be available within about 2 kilometers, whereas it is 13 kilometer. This project is located at this place because the power plant is nearby. Already they have got a permission for a power plant, that is why they are locating. And there is a software called HiPAC. If you give the bathymetry survey means what is the water depth at different locations before construction of port. Then you put the location of the breakwater, navigation channel and other training circle, then it will calculate the capital dredging inside the basin as well as the approach channel, that is coming to be about 24 million cubic meter. This is also very high. For a Gopalpur port which we discussed, it is only 5 million cubic meter, whereas it is 5 times costly, 24 million cubic meter. Approximately 10% of this will be your maintenance dredging. For engineering and when you want to work in a design organization, you should have certain numbers. You cannot have the maintenance dredging about 30% of the capital dredging. It cannot be 1% also. Generally, it is between 5 to 10%. If you are not getting within the bandwidth, you have to check whether there is any mistake or otherwise. This particular project, southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon, the deposition rate is almost the same, but generally it does not happen like that. in some places southwest monsoon the deposition will be higher compared to northeast monsoon. We have divided this into four equal months. Sometimes southwest monsoon is taken 6 months and northeast 3 months and fair weather 3 months. It depends on the location. Any doubts in this? Because we are going to the next study. This is that I have not written here. Once you dredge it, both capital and maintenance dredging, this also I discussed in one of the lecture, how to dispose the material. This Mike 21 has different modules. One of the modules can be used for this study. We are assuming that the total dredging will be completed over a period of 12 months, that is the duration of this dredging operation. Then we have to choose a disposal area. This is at a distance of 25 kilometer from the shore towards east into the sea, and the water depth is considered is about 30 meters. Sometimes we consider 50 meter also. So the disposal is carried out at a water depth of 30 meter. The area over which the disposal takes place is about 3500 by 3500 meters, and we are simulating from 1st January to 31st December 2008 for 1 year period. And we have different locations, I think 16 locations I think, and we will be studying the dumping at these 16 locations. This is your breakwater, this is your entrance channel, this is the location for dumping area. Here we have given grid spacing into 400 meters, that means if it is 60 into 400 is 24 kilometers. There is something wrong here. No, no, it is not starting from 0, okay, starting from 28. So this distance is about 24 kilometers. One of my student has done a mistake. He has not multiplied by the grid spacing. He told that 80 meter we are getting 25 meter contour. Got the point? Whenever you use a commercial software or general purpose software, you please read the manual. Normally we do not do it. Even if you buy some equipment, kitchen equipment or electrical equipment, just open the box and put the plug and start using it. You should not do it. You have to read the manual. Similarly, I have seen many youngsters who are venturing into this, they do not read the manual. But when we started working in numerical methods using software, we generally do not use the commercial softwares. We develop our own softwares. In that case, we know what is inside. So what you are doing is a black box. At least when you use a black box, you read the manual, then start doing it. This color code gives the water depth at various locations. So here it is darker, mainly because we are dredging it here more. So this is how this water depth has been simulated. So here also we are deciding into fair weather. I did not say which is the fair weather. Fair weather is from January to April. The maximum seabed level rise will be about a meter over the disposal area and 0.5 meter rise in seabed level extending to 1 kilometer around the disposal area. So suppose this is the point of disposal. Here it will be rising. This green color is here, 0.5 to 1 meter. And at a distance of about a kilometer on all the sides, this will increase to 0.5 meter. That is this 0.1 to 0.5 meter it will increase. So when you dispose the material here, how much increase in the bed level, that is what is being shown here. This is during the southwest monsoon. So if you see here disposal, it is uniform around the disposal point, it is symmetric. Both the directions. What is happening here? it is not symmetric. Why? There are two types of currents, one is a tidal current, another is a wave induced current. This is mainly due to wave induced current, because in fair weather also you will have the same tidal currents. So, southwest monsoon means the waves will be moving in this direction, so the sediment is displaced here. This black patch correspond to about 2 meter, 1 to 1.5 and 1.5 to 2 meter increase in bed level, and about a distance of 5 kilometer, earlier it was only 1 kilometer, now at a distance of 5 kilometer the bed level increases by 0.5 meter. And another important aspect what we interested is the sediments should not move towards the coastline. The dispersed sediment do not move towards the coast, and it mostly spread parallel to the coastline. It is also within the deep water. See, we are bringing a vessel with 16-17 meter draft, let us say, and here the water depth is 25 meter, it will be less by 1.5 meter, 23.5, still you have sufficient margin. But MOEF says the bed level should not increase more than 0.5 meters. So, subsequently this grid spacing, that area over which the disposal to be carried out, has been revised. This is a peculiar in northeast monsoon. We did not expect that to go like this, but it is going in both the direction during the northeast monsoon. And northeast monsoon also the quantity of sediment is very high over the patch, 1.5 meter. See, northeast monsoon is very difficult to predict. If you see the wave rose diagram, it is not always unidirectional, and sometimes you have some waves coming from the east also, and depends on the site also, what is the input data we are giving. If you are, we have to give a input data, what is the input data we are giving, we have to simulate different wave heights and wave periods and wave directions. So, all these things will have an influence on this. I have to see what input they have given. It depends on the location where we are disposing. Location means your Windrose diagram. Unfortunately, I do not have this, but it should not be like this, it should be mirror image of this. Whatever is shown here, it should be the mirror image of this. Maybe we will see the tranquility at that time, we will see what is the angle we are using. So, we have given 16 locations, you give the UTM coordinates and the volume, how much you are disposing in each location. What we have to do is you start from the first location and go to the 16th location, then come back to the first location and then do the 16th location, like that you should continuously do. This is done for capital dredging, the same thing can be done for maintenance dredging also. So, these are the two studies which we have done, one is the sediment transport and the dredge disposal. The next study is wave tranquility study. So, you are supposed to know about this elliptic mild slope wave model, this equation is there which is used to solve this problem. So, we have to study the wave tranquility for a single wave height, wave period and wave direction. Whenever you do this type of modeling, one of the main requirement is what is the area you are taking for the study. Here we are taking 2.5 by 2 kilometer. Suppose you do not take the area properly, then also the model will fail. The second one is what is the spacing of the grid points, that should be 2.5 meter, it is a fairly close grid which we are using. And we have 800,000 computational points within this grid. So, we need the bathymetry, it is a iterative method, we have to describe that, then we have to provide the boundary condition. Some of them are absorbing, some of them are partial reflection, that means if there is a breakwater, it will absorb some of the wave energy, that has to be given. If it is a vertical wall, it may reflect, those boundary conditions to be given, and we have to give the wave input. I have given the wave height is 1 meter, but if the wave height is higher or lower, we can multiply correspondingly because it is a linear analysis. Suppose in fair weather wave height is 0.5 meter, in southwest monsoon 1.5, northwest monsoon 1.2, you can multiply whatever results you have got by the corresponding magnitude. That is why you are doing it for unit wave height. The fair weather, the wave direction is assumed as 90 degrees, southwest monsoon 135 degrees and northeast monsoon 45 degrees. And then we do the analysis for each wave period, each one has to be done separately. You have to have the model and do the analysis for 1 meter 90 degrees and 6 second, then 8 second, 10 second, 12 second, then 1 meter 135 degrees, 6 second, 8, 10, 12, like that you have to do for all these combinations. This is not the total area in which the study has been carried out. That is done for I think slightly higher area I think, but the fair weather season the waves are coming like this. That red color indicates about 1 meter, it goes straight away into 1 meter here, and the bursts are located somewhere here. This is the point where container bursts are located. This is the point, this is the area over which we have the coal berth located. Very close to the berthing area we have lesser wave heights, that is 0.2 to 0.4 meters. When you see about 8 second, 10 second and 12 seconds, it gets reduced here, it gets reduced to 0.6 to 0.8, that is what is written here. For 6 second waves, all the waves remain same as 1 meter, but higher period waves, when it goes inside, the wave heights become lesser. The better tranquility has been observed on both sides of the approach channel inside the harbor. This is the approach channel, so on either side of this we have better tranquility. So this is about the southwest monsoon and northwest monsoon. So here you will get a different pattern. Here southwest monsoon the waves are going like this, 135 degrees, it will penetrate like this, and you will have better tranquility on this side of the berth. And this is the northeast monsoon, the wave will penetrate here like this, and you will have a better tranquility here. Understood this tranquility studies, that is showing the wave heights at different points. Finally, when a ship is to be in this location, you have to see what is the permissible wave height. You have to multiply that unit wave height by the corresponding wave height and see and tell how many days the berth can be operational. Based on the studies, they have decided to extend one of the breakwater further. That was the conclusion. The next model is lateral drift. This is very important for shoreline evaluation. That is the third study which I have written here. This is developed by one institute called Danish Hydraulic Institute. We will be using this model for finding out the shoreline changes. The shoreline changes occur due to construction of breakwater, onshore offshore transport, change in bed profile in breaker zone and lateral currents. These are the various requirements. This lead drift model consists of two parts, one is the hydrodynamic model, another is the sediment transport model. So this transport is for each incident wave occurring over the year. We get the 3-hourly wave data. Generally we record this 3-hourly wave data which is used as the input. So, this shows the flow chart for this module. You have to get the wave, wind and current data, you have to get the sediment data, you have to get the bathymetry data. Wave, wind and current data typically consists of for wave it is wave height, wave period and direction, wind is wind speed and direction, current also the direction and the velocity. Bathymetry data means water depth at various locations. Sediment data means they will give the particle size, D50 size. One of the class I explained what is D50 size, that has to be input. Then we have to input the incident wave, longshore current, point selection to transport calculations, then longshore transport, then we have to calculate the lateral drift. They write about the orientation of the coast because generally the orientation of the coast is not parallel to north south. So, you have to mark the orientation of the coast. Normally the orientations, the directions, everything is given with reference to the true north. This shows the quantity of sediment, this sediment transport. So, there is a difference between what we are calculating here and what is shown there, what is shown in the first slide, that is to find out the sediment transport beyond the breaker zone. Breaker zone means where the wave break, and here shoreline evaluation we are very much interested about the sedimentation from the shore to the breaker zone. Let us say 1 meter the wave is breaking, what we discussed earlier is beyond the breakwater which is about 2 kilometers. Here it is 0 to 1 kilometer, that is the width. So, this annual is like this, net is very small, this is 10 power 6, it is not 106. This typical of that coast, this coast is near Nagapattinam where the lateral drift is nearly 0. You have a northerly drift and southerly drift which are equal and opposite, and there is no net drift, that means there would not be any severe change in the shoreline evaluation. So, this shows the results what is happening. This is your shoreline or the coastal line. And this has been developed for about 250 meter into the sea. Here the distance from the breakwaters are shown, these two are the north and south breakwaters, they are extending for about 2.5 kilometers, each breakwater is going for about 2.5 kilometers, but we are showing only 250 meters. And here we are showing first year, fifth year, 10th year and 25th year. This is the first year, fifth year, 10th year and 25th year. The shoreline adjacent to the breakwater gets deposited both the sides, north as well as the south. Deposition is more on the southern side, less on the, you see the distance, it is deposited up to about 160-170 meters, whereas here it is 100 meters. The distance from here is about this 5 kilometer, this is from 15 to 25 about 10 kilometers, here it is about 8 kilometers. Afterwards there is no effect of this breakwater. So, the breakwater is about 2.5 kilometers, 3 times the length of the breakwater, afterwards you cannot see any effect. What you are seeing is this is the original shoreline, for a small distance there is a deposition, afterwards there is a erosion. The erosion is about 25 meters, it is almost the same on either side, about 25 meters. So, this is not a very serious issue as far as this particular project is concerned, but if you see the Chennai port where we have the breakwater originally built like this. Whatever figure I have shown there, the deposition has taken place like this. This much area has got deposited. That is why you are seeing the Marina Beach and all. Then this, there was an entrance channel here. So when this deposition takes place, it goes and gets deposited here again. This is what has happened. Then what they did is they extended this breakwater further towards this side. This also got bypassed and they extended one more like this. The problem of this deposition getting it goes to the entrance channel is the maintenance dredging will be very high, so it should be avoided. The another aspect is here the deposition is seen on both the sides, whereas in this particular project for this Chennai coastline, the erosion has taken place like this. This distance is more than 200 meters. This deposition is on an average is more than 500 meters. So about 200 meter of coastline have got eroded on the northern side. It is a pessimistic figure only, but sometimes it has gone even 400, 500 meter also on the northern side. Subsequently, our department only has given some solution to this. We have given some groin fields like this for about 8 to 10 kilometers, and afterwards only this there was a highway which was going on this side, the national highway going to Calcutta. They will lay the road and the road will disappear. One season only it will be there, then again they will shift the road towards inside, like that they are doing. For this particular project Chennai port, the net drift is 1 million cubic meter. Here it is nearly 0, whereas there it is 1 million cubic meter towards north. South north is about 1.3 million cubic meter, north south is about 0.3 million cubic meter, net drift is 1 million cubic meter. But even now there is the bypassing is taking place. Even today after this extension, they were not able to arrest the, this is called as a bypassing of sediments. They use the entrance channel as the silt trap and they are removing the sediments which are there in the entrance channel. So to summarize, in this particular site, the sediment transport beyond the breaker zone only deposits in the entrance channel, whereas in a harbor like Chennai port, it is a sediment transport beyond the breaker zone as well as the bypassing of the sediments. Both the things will contribute to the deposition. But after some years, about 30-40 years, this will get stabilized. Shows in detail what happened after a period of 1 year, up to 5 years, up to 10 years. To summary, the maximum accretion close to the southern breakwater of 25 years is limited to 170 meter and that along the southern breakwater is 120 meter. So what they are telling is this is 170 meter and this is 120 meter. Maximum erosion is limited to 25 meter on both sides of breakwaters. So this is the 25 meter, this is the erosion on both sides of the breakwaters. No change line, shoreline has been modified beyond 5 kilometer on either side of the shoreline. So if you see the distance from here, about 5 kilometer and 5 kilometer, there is virtually very negligible change. So what is to be done for the shoreline stabilization? So we do not need a bypassing arrangements. Bypassing arrangement means you remove the sediment from the southern side and put it on the northern side. So we do not need this If anything is seen, then we can go for a bypassing program.